this is how a Shinkansen bullet train factory is made in Japan. So today we are in Hamamatsu, Shizuoka, and I got a special one for you. I'm taking you to a Shinkansen bullet train factory today, and I'm gonna take you on a full tour. So I've never done this before, I've never gone inside of a train factory. In fact, I've kind of always wanted to do this, and now today we get to do it. So I'm super, super excited for this. But before I start, if you guys wanna see what I'm doing on the daily, then check out my Instagram account. If you guys wanna help support the channel, check out my Japan merch. And if you have any questions about Japan or Japan travels, then check out my Discord community. Let's get started with this factory tour. Let me take you inside. So I'm here at the JR Central Hamamatsu Workshop, aka Train Factory. It's the one and only location in Japan that conducts a complete overhaul inspection that fully disassembles, repairs, and reassembles the Tokaido Shinkansen bullet trains, the most popular and busiest train line in Japan. It started as a repair shop in 1912 for steam locomotives, and over time as technology evolved, so did the workshop, servicing trains across the ages from electronic locomotives, electric trains, and now Shinkansen. Today, there are a total of about 1,300 hardworking JR Central staff and affiliated workers who come together at the workshop to ensure that all of their Shinkansen trains are operated at peak performance and safety. And what do you know, I'm the first YouTube content creator to ever visit this workshop, so we're going Shinkansen long with this one. Alright, so I made it inside, but today I think I'm going to be wearing something a little bit different. Let's see what I'm going to wear. There you go, let's go inside of the factory now. So I've got my helmet on, time to find the trains. Hi, can you show me inside?
わかりました。 本日は特別に浜松工場をお見せいたします。 こちらへどうぞ。
Wow, the Shinkansen workshop is so massive, and why I want to call it a train factory or even train maintenance plant to better capture its scale. The entire property is about 318,000 square meters, just over 78 acres. Oh, there's a Shinkansen coming into the plant. Right after the train arrives, it goes through its first inspection and diagnostic, which determines what types of extra maintenance and service is required. So I got into this area, let's see what's going on here. After the initial inspection, the train is ushered into the Mae Sagyoba, pre-maintenance area. A Shinkansen train usually consists of 16 carriage cars, but coming into this area, it's already been separated into 4 stripped-down carriage cars. In order to maintain and service the Shinkansen, the workers must take it apart section by section and then piece by piece, as each must go through a strict and rigorous inspection process. This requires for each piece to be transported to various areas of the plant so different teams can work on the different sections simultaneously, hence the requirement for so much space. In fact, the workers are divided into 4 teams: body, parts, undercarriage, and inspection. And each worker required to master a unique set of skills for their section before being allowed to service the train. Oh, they're disassembling the seats now! It seems like there's a lot for them to do. In fact, there's so much work that takes place in the Mae Sagyoba that it requires about 60 workers to finish one carriage. Wow, everything's gone! So I'm inside of the train right now and you can see that it's all taken apart. It's pretty awesome. Oh cool, let's go see what's up here. So I'm just above the train right now. I climbed the stairs and you can see it's a little bit dirty, but by the time it gets out of here, it's gonna be polished and cleaned up.
Once the 4 carriage cars have been stripped, they're individually separated and moved to the dismantling warehouse.
So I think I've just arrived a little bit early, but the train should be coming here and they're gonna separate the body and the wheelbase.
In order to move the train carriages onto the service tracks, they're attached to powerful orange vehicles called train pullers, which can pull up to 4 carriages at one time. Oh, and that's a traverser, which moves the trains from one warehouse to the next. Damn, I don't know what it is though, but for some reason, watching a Shinkansen moving laterally is so mesmerizing.
Depending on the warehouse location, the entire moving process could take up to 15 minutes. To say the least, it's a massive effort to move these train cars, so it's always performed slowly and cautiously to ensure safety of all of the workers. The Hamamatsu Workshop Factory works on up to 4 Shinkansen at one time. In fact, they inspect and repair about 50 Shinkansen, 800 carriages, each year.
これ、11名上昇します。
Now that the carriage is safely secured inside of the dismantling warehouse, a new team of workers can start their tasks. First, the entire train carriage is raised up via specifically designed lifts to allow for safe undercarriage access. These powerful machines can lift a train that weighs up to 40 tons, about 2.5 meters high. Let's go talk to that person. Hi, what are you doing?
はい、リフティングジャッキを使用して車体を持ち上げています。台車を車体から切り離す作業を行うためです。
So what's your favorite thing about this entire process?
実際に車体に触りながら作業ができるところがとても魅力的です。
Thank you.
ありがとうございました。
Once fully lifted, the workers begin to separate the train body from the undercarriage, as well as the removal of underfloor equipment. Again, all these sections and parts are destined for a separate warehouse in the plant. And what's truly amazing about this process is how much, even with such a massive scale transportation vehicle like a Japanese bullet train, is performed by worker technical skill and hand. Each worker, though, is required to engage in a 2.5 month training program at the start of their career, culminating into a strict in-house test certification that must be passed, plus any additional training and licenses for jobs like a crane operator, ultimately facilitating an efficient and safe working environment. Damn, look at that train puller go! It guides the undercarriage into this orange undercarriage traverser, which automatically transports them into a neighboring warehouse for inspection and maintenance. After the undercarriage has been detached, the workers focus on disassembling the electronics and other equipment under the carriage. This is a critical part in the process as the workers must be diligent in taking inventory of all the parts removed to ensure that not a single piece is misplaced. As an important piece of their workflow, workers use specialized tablets to track each individual part and information about each part so that it properly gets maintained and reassembled in the correct location. At the same time, smaller parts like bolts and screws are generally replaced with new ones. So before we continue on, I want to give a quick shout out to the sponsor for this video, Squarespace. If you all don't already know, Squarespace is the number one way to build your online presence. In fact, I use Squarespace for my website, Tokyo Zebra. Here are just some of the reasons why I love using Squarespace so much. Whether you're starting your passion project or building a business, Squarespace has all the tools to get it done while also looking ultra sleek and professional at the same time. They support numerous portfolios and gallery designs, which you can customize and even password protect so the right people see your work. Use its fully integrated blogging tools and commenting features such as threaded comments, replies, and likes to help engage your community. And my personal favorite, built-in analytics to see how your visits, unique visitors, and page views trend over time. Go to squarespace.com today for your free trial. When you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/Paolo from Tokyo and get 10% off your first domain or website. Cool, let's continue on. While the body is transported to the cleaning warehouse, let's follow the undercarriage to see what happens to it in the next building. This place literally is just blowing me away. It is so massive. There's just so much space, but I guess it makes sense when you're dealing with so many trains that come through here. This is amazing. You can see just behind me, they're taking the wheels off the base. The undercarriage, daisha in Japanese, is composed of the frame chassis, wheels, axles, and motors. In order for the undercarriage to be fully inspected, each part must be disassembled to separately undergo its own exhaustive testing. As the components are separated, they're sent to diagnostics, and parts like the axles are inspected via ultrasonic sensors, magnetic particles, and fiberscope to ensure it's free from defects, while wheels are turned and reprofiled with an accuracy of a tenth of a millimeter. Even the smallest of components, such as the bearings, are inspected. Oh wow, that giant orange crane is used for lifting up the frame! Alright, let's see what's going on here! Oh, this is their undercarriage operation inspection room! Once all of the undercarriage components pass their individual inspections, they're reassembled to make a complete undercarriage, which then undergoes a running test at speeds of 300 kilometers per hour, or about 806 miles per hour, the same top speed the Shinkansen would operate on their fastest stretch on the Sanyo line. Hi, can I ask you some questions?
はい。
What are you doing?
台車が正常に動作するかの確認の検査を行っています。300キロを超える台車ですので、振動や音、温度だったり異常がないかを確認しています。
Does it ever fail?
綿密な検査を行っておりますので、ほとんどありません。
What do you do when that happens?
原因を特定して各部品を変えております。
So is there anything you need to be really careful about when doing this task?
はい。新幹線の台車ですので、各部品一つ一つのボルトをしっかり締まっているか確認するところに力を入れております。
Thank you.
はい、ありがとうございます。
Once the automated test has run its course and the undercarriage receives a passing result, it must then undergo a manual inspection in order to move on to the next stage. And this is where all of the disassembled equipment and parts are cleaned and repaired.
Huh, this is kind of interesting. Let's see what's behind that door over there.
Hey guys! What are you doing?
こちらはセット材料といって、パンタグラフなどの装置の組み立てに使用する材料を一つ一つ今並べているところです。
Why do you have to do this?
こちらのトレーに一つ一つ並べることで、取り付け間違いだったり、取り付け忘れ、これを防止しています。
Looking spiffy! This room is where the pantograph gets inspected and maintained. You know, the top part of the train that connects to the electrical power lines? Interestingly, all of the components used for equipment inspection and repair are prepared in advance, and a component such as bolts and packaging are preset in a fixed position in dedicated trays. In total, there are about 450 different component kit trays to help manage parts, and about 300 unique trays are used in one day.
Look at this, even every single tool has their spot. So I'm right in front of the lead Shinkansen train and it's gonna be polished right now.
After the body is thoroughly cleaned and repaired, it's transferred to the Toso warehouse, body paint. So this giant transparently walled area is where the Shinkansen body gets polished. The Shinkansen is so massive that automated robot arms are used to ensure that the paint is applied evenly. And just before this, the lead car of the Shinkansen receives a specialized automated polishing treatment in this specific area due to its unique aerodynamic shape. The polishing creates a more adhesive surface for the paint application. The other carriages are moved to a separate area that's more equipped for standard sidewalls and roof polishing.
And here it looks like the body and the wheelbase has been reattached.
This is the Gisaba warehouse, aka assembly area. Here, the newly painted body, undercarriage, and undercarriage equipment are reassembled. Also, any components previously removed from the carriage interior are reinstalled to create one functioning train car. Once all of the work is complete, it's moved to the final departure warehouse. By the way, each train must pass 4 levels of periodic inspection, with each level becoming more and more exhaustive, so inspections are performed every 48 hours, then every 60,000 kilometers about 45 days, after that every 600,000 kilometers about 18 months, and finally at 1.2 million kilometers or every 36 months, which again is the most detailed inspection as it's a complete teardown, repair, and rebuild taking about 14 days to fully complete, and the very inspection that I'm showing you today. The traverser requires 2 trained workers for operation, one on each end to ensure safety. Today, there are a total of 3 workers as one of them is a trainee, being instructed on how to safely operate the vehicle. So this is where the individual carriages are finally joined to form one fully functioning and operational 16-car Shinkansen bullet train. The recoupling process is performed slowly and carefully as the workers make small adjustments by hand to ensure a safe and secure connection.
Thank you.
After the train is reconnected, workers reaffix the connecting panels and electrical cables between the carriages. And from here, the Shinkansen must still undergo an additional 1400 tests in 117 different categories to ensure it's working properly and safe for passengers to ride.
Shinkansen
So they're doing their final inspections right now at the factory, and after that, the train is gonna leave.
As part of the final test, the Shinkansen performs a test run and operates between Hamamatsu and Nagoya. To further ensure a safe and comfortable ride for passengers, the final test includes items such as acceleration, deceleration, stopping, vibration in the cabin, and cabin air pressure in tunnels. Only after fully passing all of these tests is the Shinkansen bullet train reintroduced into operation.
So that's how a Shinkansen factory is made in Japan. If you guys like this video, help me out and hit that like button. If you guys want to see more videos like this or anything related to Japan, hit that subscribe button and the bell button, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.